Chris Menard here. Let's take a look at the geometric mean. We're going to use Microsoft Excel. I'm going to explain what the geometric mean is. We'll look at the geometric mean versus the average. I have three examples, including a financial investment example. Let's dive in right now. So the geometric mean is the central tendency of a group of numbers. It uses multiplication compared to the average, which uses addition or summation. Here's example number one, just to explain this. Over in column A, I've got these numbers here. Down in cell A8, if I want to know what is the average, I'm going to use the average function. And the average is 22,222. So if you notice, the average is greater, 1, 2, 3, than 4 of the 5 numbers. The average is calculated in Excel by taking the sum of those numbers and then dividing by the count of those numbers. I get the exact same answer. So the average uses summation. The geometric mean uses multiplication. So I'm going to go ahead and do the function first. Geo mean, highlight the numbers, and I get 1,000. If you want to do this manually, it is using multiplication. So I'm going to take, it's basically taking 10 times 100 times 1,000, on and on. We have an Excel function for that. It is called the product function. So all those numbers multiplied times each other is million, billion, trillion, quadrillion. So that's 1 quadrillion. And then it takes those and raises them to the power of the numbers. So I could do this all in one formula, but let me just finish this off. It's going to take that number, raised to the power of 1, divided by 5. We have 5 numbers. And look, I get the exact same 1,000. I could have wrote that all as one formula. But what's nice is we do have an Excel function for the geo mean. And of course, we have an Excel function for the average. Now, here's a great example. So that was just explaining how they worked. Example number two, before I get into this financial example, let's say we have a group of employees and we all have similar tasks. And we know that this task should take between 5 days and 25 days is what we're estimating. So one employee gets it and it takes them 7 days, another does it in 6. The third employee, though, takes 150 days. Why did it take 150 days? So from the start date, when they got it, they began working on it. And I'm making this up. They went out on FMLA. We did not assign it to anyone else. We forgot to. They came back and then they finished. Another employee, for some reason, left the company and it took us a while to reassign it to somebody. And that one took, let's make this 98 days. And then finally, we have another couple other tasks, 6 days, 15, 20, that works. So if I go figure out the average from here, and someone says, what's the average number of days? 43.1429. Well, what's the geometric average? Geo mean, highlight those numbers. The 19.6 is a much better number than the 43.129. It doesn't put as much weight on the higher numbers and the lower numbers. So that is one great example of why I would use this. Example number three is a financial one, and this is my favorite example. So over in cell E2, we do an $1,000 investment. And then in year one, it increased 10%. In year two, it went down 12%. Year three, 90% increase. 4, 30% decrease, and finally in year 5, a 25% increase. If I just take these numbers, the 1,000 times D3, which is the 110%, there we go. Let's see what we end up with at the end of this investment. So the $1,000 became $1,609. I lost the decimal places, no big deal. If you come in here and average these percentages, which is really a wrong answer, trust me, I'm going to average those 5 percentages and I end up with 17% increase on our investment. That's what we tell people, is we make a 17% annual growth on that. That is wrong. If we use the geometric average, highlight those, 109.98. I'm showing the two decimals here for a reason. If you want to test this, the 109.98 is the accurate number. That is your compound annual growth rate. So if I do this one more time, I'm going to go to F2 and type in 1,000. And then we will use F2 times D10, the 109.98. We're going to use absolute reference. Auto fill this down. I better get 1,609. And I get 1,609. So that is why in finance and in business and frequently in biology and other, they use the geometric mean compared to the average. I will put more details about the geometric mean down into the description of this video. Appreciate your support. My online training classes are available down below. Have a wonderful day.